my friends, welcome. You see I'm wearing today a t-shirt with a Ukrainian symbol, and I invite you to have a look at the video which is showing the numerous signs of solidarity in many European countries. Today we are in the bathroom that you've already seen for unblocking the bathtub, and I will be changing these spots because these spots are not foreseen for wet rooms like a bathroom, so we'll be replacing them with the right spots. Let's go! Like in other works related to lightning, we will either cut the whole electricity in the house or just the relevant circuit, which is this year. Now there's no electricity here, so I can touch the spotlight however I want. So first of all, we're removing it. For removing the old spots, it's useful to know that there are these clamps on the back. So just pull it so that the clamps are inverted. Now I have opened the four spots which are in the bathroom. I discovered there are two transfers. The new lamps I'm installing are not requiring any transfer, which makes that I will now remove them and I will check how this is wired. A very important difference between these two is that this old spot was working with a low tension, requiring then a transfer, whereas this one, the new one, is working with a normal tension of the house, so we don't need to put any transfer. So we start by removing this transfer. Removing all the connectors. So now, very careful, you see that there are different wires coming out of the ceiling, and try to identify what is connected to which one. And make sure that you're not losing the cables, otherwise they will be very difficult to recover. So here, for instance, this one is moving over there, this one is moving over there, and here I have two simple wires, which probably means that these are the connections between these two. So now we are connecting everything together. For the new spots, you see here this standard, which is IP65, which means that it's suitable for wet rooms. Of course, first read the installation notice.
see here, this is the connector to the bulb. It's already pre-stripped. And then we have this feature, and to the difference of the other one, you can see that first of all, there is a joint here. And secondly, that there's a little window here, avoiding the humidity to reach the installation. Further comment, here there's already a wire which is in the box. Just make sure that you have the right socket for the bulb. Here my shop advised me to take these ones for fitting with this type of bulb. And you have also the choice between cold white light or warmer yellowish light. Here I choose the bright white. In terms of connectors, I will use these little dominoes. So the little ones in case there's only one wire, and the bigger ones in case there are two big wires to connect together.
Take a big domino for ensuring the connection between the big wires.
Here I'm connecting the arrival of the electricity. This is the black wire with the red wire, which is the bridge to the other spot. And then I'm connecting the arrival of electricity here, the blue wire connected with the brown wire for the bridge to the other spot. The colors of the wires are not very important here because we are installing class 2 lighting. Two comments here. It would have been by far easier to use clipsable wackos. And the second is, in case you're using dominoes, it is by far easier if you are cutting the piece in two because the wires are very rigid. If you want to have a concrete illustration about these two points, don't hesitate to have a look at the video about the installation of low tension spots. And finally, we are placing the socket of the spot. And again, here, as the diameter of the wires is different, clipsable wackos would have been advantageous.
Repeating this exercise on the other arrivals. One little hint here, this is a big domino, so that it's for making sure that it holds. I will push the little wire here up to where there is the protection. Now all the circuits are placed and I will make a test before putting everything back in place. Okay, the four lights are working, which means that we can now put back the protections.
You can see here perfectly the feathers which are maintaining the spotlight within the ceiling. Here I took the option of placing the bulb directly into the spotlight. Another option is to install the spotlight and then to get the socket for putting the bulb.
You see here this little ring which we will remove, placing the bulb.
Now we put the ring back.
Not forgetting to put the little joint. For putting it back, I put back the feathers. Now we're storing all this back into the roof. And then we're putting the little window.
And don't forget the joint between the spotlight and the glass. And you see here the little grooves which enable to fix the glass on the spotlight.
That's it, my friends. So now all the spots are perfectly fixed. Good to have spots specifically foreseen for wet places like a bathroom. This will avoid future hassle in the installation. You noted that I made the works being on a ladder, so don't hesitate to have a look at the video about the 6 golden rules for your safety on a ladder. I have plenty other examples and videos about lightning, suspension, wall lamp, inside, outside. So don't hesitate to have a look at these. And I'm also covering many other subjects. So see you very soon on Happy Hour TV 1.